It's 2016, and we've seen phonographs, vinyl, cassette tapes, compact discs, MP3s, and now vinyl. What? That can't be right. Hey, fellow hipsters, Jules here for D News. Vinyl has existed for almost a century, and over that time, what we think of as vinyl has changed quite a bit. Some picture gramophone records, but really, vinyl is everywhere. It's in your flooring, your t-shirts, your phone, and depending on your medical history, it could even be inside your body. Vinyl can be black, colorful, or transparent. It can be solid or semi-liquid. It can even be a very short-lived HBO drama starring Olivia Wilde. R.I.P. The versatility of vinyl cannot be denied, but what the hell is it? Well, vinyl is a plastic made from two basic compounds, chlorine, which is also found in salt, and ethylene, which is found in natural gas. These are combined in a chemical reaction to create ethylene dichloride, which is turned into a gas, and then through a process called polymerization, it becomes a fine white powder called polyvinyl chloride, or PVC. Side note, in the United States, we often use the terms PVC and vinyl interchangeably, but in other places, vinyl can refer to specific applications of the plastic, like flooring or artificial leather. Either way, PVC resin is the foundation for all vinyl, and perhaps surprisingly, it was discovered by accident. Twice. Two different chemists in the 19th century left vinyl chlorine gas out in the sun to discover that over time it transforms into a white solid. After numerous failed attempts to make use of PVC, an American successfully plasticized it in the 1920s and began experimenting with it as a cheaper and more durable alternative to rubber and to other plastics. Initially, the material only made appearances in random household items, like shower curtains, insulated wire, and raincoats. Then, in the 1930s, PVC manufacturing plants sprung up, and vinyl made its way into industrial applications, like gaskets and tubing. Today, vinyl is manufactured and sold more than any other plastic in the world, short of polyethylene. And of course, it's used for records. But at first, it wasn't. Originally, records were made from shellac, another plastic that's today found in fake nails and wood finish. However, each side of the shellac discs could only play about 3 to 4 minutes of music, and record companies realized that if they wanted a longer playing record, they'd need a tougher material, one that could handle smaller grooves. By the 1950s, pretty much all record companies had switched to vinyl. So, vinyl is obviously prolific. It's durable, recyclable, cheap to manufacture, and can be made into just about anything. But is it environmentally friendly? Vinyl manufacturers and trade organizations say yes, because PVC is mostly made from a compound based on salt, a natural material, and it supposedly uses less energy to manufacture than other plastics. However, environmentalists and the EPA say that PVC production releases dioxins and pollutants, and you could be exposed to them by inhaling polluted air near manufacturing facilities. You can also unknowingly intake harmful chemicals through eating foods in PVC-lined packaging and drinking water transported in PVC pipes. This could lead to anything from dizziness, drowsiness, and headaches to liver damage and even cancer. Greenpeace calls vinyl the most damaging plastic on the planet, and has also spoken out about the dangerous toxins it emits when it's burned. Whether vinyl is good or bad, it's kind of impossible to avoid. If it's not in your clothes or your computer, it's in the walls of your home or lining the tubes that transport your water. So maybe just chill. Put on a record or something. And while you're chilling, think of all the time you've wasted not working out on your beach bod. That's what I do every day. But don't get too depressed, it's not too late, because you can check out Beachbody On Demand. I know I did. Check them out at beachbody.com, where you can get access to a wide variety of workout programs, including the world famous P90X, Insanity, Focus T25, and a bunch of others, ranging from cardio to resistance training, yoga, dance, low impact, and more. Sign up for Beachbody On Demand today and get a free 30-day membership. So vinyl is potentially harmful. Are there less harmful plastics? What about those biodegradable ones? Are those actually good for the environment? Find out in this video by Trace.
It takes hundreds of years for plastic bottles to degrade. Not biodegrade, mind you, just degrade. Bacteria do not digest plastic in the environment. Instead, the plastic degrades under UV radiation, usually, or ocean punishment, and the pieces get smaller and smaller until they become invisible, but are still there, part of our environment forever.
Do you collect vinyl records at home? If so, what's your favorite? Let us know down below in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe to D News for more videos every day.